Okay, let us discuss a problem on turbo machine. In the this will be in module 1. The velocity of fluid from a nozzle in an axial flow turbine. It is given that it is an axial flow impulse turbine. If it is an axial flow impulse turbine or axial flow turbine, inlet and outlet will be at the same radius. Therefore, tangential speed of the rotor u1 will be equal to u2, it will be equal to u. It will be same at the inlet as well as outlet, and it is having a velocity of 1200 meter per second. Means it is the absolute velocity of the steam, that is p equal to p. At the inlet it is 1200 meter per second, therefore we will take it as V1 is equal to 1200 meter per second. And the nozzle angle. Nozzle angle means it is the angle between tangential velocity of rotor and absolute velocity. Therefore, nozzle angle alpha will be alpha 1. Nozzle angle will be equal to alpha 1. It is equal to 22 degree. The blades are equiangular. Blade angle is beta. Blades are equiangular means beta 1 is equal to beta 2. It is equal to, let it be beta. The rotor tangential speed means it is u. It is equal to 400 meter per second. 400 meter per second. This is given data. To find is, you have to calculate blade angles to find. First, we will draw velocity triangle. Let us consider a rotor. Let this be a rotor which is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Along this rotor, if you draw a tangent to the rotor at the inlet, if you draw a tangent to the rotor at the inlet, it will be like this. This is a tangent to the rotor at the inlet. It will be like this. It will be a tangent to the rotor at the inlet. This always represents relative velocity. Pr1, it is at the inlet, therefore it is relative velocity Pr1. In the similar way, if we draw tangent to the rotor at the outlet, that represents again relative velocity. It represents relative velocity Pr2. Okay. Now, tangential velocity of rotor will always be like this. It is rotating in the anticlockwise direction, therefore tangential velocity of rotor will be from right to left, u1. The vector summation of pr1 and u1 represents p1, that is absolute velocity v1. This is p1. This one is alpha 1. Alpha 1 is the angle between absolute velocity and tangential velocity. This is beta 1. Beta 1 is the angle between relative velocity and tangential velocity measured in the direction of the rotation of the rotor. And horizontal component of absolute velocity, this is Vu1. Horizontal component of absolute velocity Vu1. Vertical component of absolute velocity Vf1. Okay, these are the, for any velocity triangle, we will get its horizontal component as Vu1, its vertical component of absolute velocity Vf1. Okay, we have drawn here it as an obtuse angle triangle, assuming that we don't know whether at the inlet the velocity triangle is obtuse angle. Here the angle is obtuse angle triangle. It may be an obtuse angle or equiangle. We have drawn it as obtuse angle triangle, assuming that Vu1 is greater than u1. After calculating Vu1, we will definitely come to know if Vu1 is greater than u1, then the whatever the velocity triangle that has been drawn, it is correct. If it is less than u1, it will be a velocity equiangle velocity triangle like this. It will be Vr1, u1 and V1. Acute angle velocity triangle, it will be like this. If Vu1 is less than u1, Vu1 is less than u1, it will be acute angle velocity triangle like this. If it is greater than u1, it will be the way we have drawn now. Okay, we will compare. After calculating, we will compare. Now, to find beta1 and beta2, to find beta1, we need Vu1 first. If we know Vu1, we can calculate, and Vf1, then we can calculate beta1 by trigonometry. Okay, first we calculate Vu1. V1 phi u1 is horizontal component of absolute velocity, phi u1, it is nothing but phi1 cos alpha 1. If we calculate, we know phi1 as 1200 meter, alpha we know. If we calculate phi1 cos alpha 1, we will get phi u1 as 112.6 meter per second. Now we can compare. Phi u1 is greater than u1, therefore whatever the velocity triangle which we have drawn, obtuse angle velocity triangle, it is right. It is right. Okay. As phi u1 is greater than u1, therefore inlet velocity triangle is obtuse angle triangle. Obtuse angle triangle. Okay. Which we have drawn, it is correct. If it is less than u1, then we have to change it as acute-angle triangle. Okay, now we have to calculate beta 1. To find out beta 1, what we need from tan theta formula? We need phi of 1. Phi of 1 is equal to phi 1 sin alpha 1. Phi 1 sin alpha 1. If we calculate phi of 1, we will get it as 449.5. We will get it as 449.5 phi of 1. Okay, using tan theta formula, tan theta is equal to opposite divided by adjacent. This side and this will be phi u1 minus u1, therefore tan beta 1 is equal to phi f1 divided by phi u1 minus u1. Okay, if we calculate here, only unknown is beta 1. If we calculate, we will calculate beta 1 is equal to 32.24 degree, we will get. Okay, which will be equal to, we know that beta 1 is equal to beta 2 as the blades are equiangular. Therefore, beta 1 is equal to 32.24 at the exit. Okay. Now, at the exit, we have drawn phi r2 in the direction tangential to the rotor at the exit. We have extended this line at the rotor, we will get phi r2 direction. Okay. U2 will be again from right to left, you will be u2. Okay, we don't know the magnitude of, u2 comparable to phi r2, therefore we have drawn a certain length of u2. This is u2 less. Okay, and this, the resultant of phi r2 and u2 is phi 2, the resultant. Okay, now we don't know whether it, the triangle after calculating will get like this or not. How to calculate is, we have to calculate phi r2 cos beta 2. You can see here, this will be phi r2 cos beta 2. If phi r2 cos beta 2 is less than u2, then we get acute angle triangle like this, whatever we have drawn. If it is greater than u2, again we will get obtuse angle triangle at the outlet only. We get acute angle triangle. Okay. Now we will calculate phi r2. We know that phi r1 is equal to phi r2. It is given in the problem. It is given that assume phi r1 is equal to phi r2. We will calculate phi r1. Phi r1 we have not yet calculated. We will calculate phi r1 from this velocity triangle. P r1 square is equal to P f1 square plus P u1 square, P u1 minus u1 bracket square, P u1 minus u1 bracket square from inlet velocity triangle. Therefore, how much we got P r1? 842.6 P r1 we will get. Okay, which will be equal to P r2? P r1 is equal to P r2. Okay, once we come to know phi r1 is equal to phi r2. Now we will calculate phi r2 cos beta 2 and we will compare it with u2 and we will decide whether the outlet velocity triangle is acute or obtuse. Now we have calculated first things, that is, we have calculated blade angle, which is beta 1 and beta 2 we have calculated. Now the second thing we need to calculate tangential force on rotor over output utilization factor. This is we have to calculate now. Okay. Now we have calculated blade angle, beta 1 and beta 2. Now we will calculate next thing. phi r1 is equal to phi r2. We will calculate phi r2 cos beta 2. We know phi r2, we know cos beta 2. If we calculate, we will get it 712 around. Okay. If we, meter per second. Now we can compare u2 with phi r2. As phi r2 cos beta 2 is greater than u2. Therefore, outlet velocity triangle what we have drawn, it is not correct. We have to correct the outlet velocity triangle. Therefore, outlet velocity triangle, will be obtuse angle triangle. Okay. Therefore, corrected outlet velocity triangle will be like this. We'll draw now. It will be like this. Or here only I can correct it. I can do that correction. It will be like this. Or you can, I will draw once again. This one is V2. It is the equitangle velocity triangle. Corrected velocity triangle will be like this. This one will be PR2 U2 and P2. Okay. This one is a corrected velocity triangle. Okay. Or else I will draw here only. It will not be a velocity triangle like this, it will be an acutangle velocity triangle. It will be, as VR2 cos beta 2 is greater than U2, it will be a velocity triangle like this. This is a corrected velocity triangle. In exam, even if you have drawn acutangle triangle initially, after that you can draw one more corrected velocity triangle like this. This is the corrected velocity triangle. Now, this is V2. If we take V2's horizontal projection, this one will be horizontal component. It will be V U2. This is U2. We know U2 is equal to U1. Suppose we now V U2 is nothing but V U2 is equal to V R2 cos beta 2 minus U. Okay. We get V U2 as 311.4. This is V U2. Now second we have to calculate tangential force. Tangential force is equal to nothing but Ft is equal to m dot P U1 plus or minus P U2. Here there are two signs, plus or minus, because if P1 and P U2 are in same direction, it should be negative. If V1 and P U2 are in opposite direction, they should be positive. Now if we see V1, P1 is, as U1 is directed from right to left, so therefore V1 direction will be from right to left like this. This is direction of V1. Direction of V U2 is in opposite direction. V U2, as V U2 is like this, it is directed towards the from left to right, therefore V U2 direction is this one. As V1 and V U2 are in opposite direction, therefore we have to use positive sign there. Okay. As right here, as V U1 and V U2 are in opposite direction, therefore Ft is equal to tangential force. Ft is equal to m dot, will take it as 1, it will be V U1 plus V U2. If they are in same direction, then it will be V U1 minus V U2. If they are in opposite direction, V U1 plus V U2. Therefore Ft will, if we calculate, we will get it as 1424 newton per kg second, as we have taken, assume m dot as 1 kg per second. Now we have to calculate power. Okay. Now we have to calculate power. What if it is plus or minus? If V1 and V U2 are in opposite direction, we have to take it as plus. Okay.
Okay, now we have to calculate power. Power formula again, Euler turbine equation. P is equal to m dot u1 p u1 plus or minus u2 p u2. If u1 and u2 are in opposite direction, it should be plus. If u1 and u2 are in same direction, it should be minus. Here we are, u1 is from right to left, u2 is from left to right, therefore it should be positive, and we assume m dot as 1, therefore it will be u1 is equal to u2, therefore it will be 400 into pu1 plus pu2. pu1 is plus pu2 is 1424. So if we calculate power, we will get it as divided by 1000 to convert watt into kilowatt, it will be in kilowatt. Okay. Therefore, P is equal to, you will get it as 569.26 kilowatt. Okay, power is equal to.